according to the adaptation, animals are divided into different categories, that are terrestrial animals, aquatic animals, arboreal animals, aerial animals, and etc. And according to the food habits of animals, animals are categorized into herbivorous, carnivorous, omnivorous, and scavengers. So in this chapter, we are going to discuss about reproduction in animals. Okay, so our topic is reproduction. R-E-P-R-O-D-U-C-T-I-O-N, reproduction. What do you mean by reproduction? Yes, reproduction means the process by which an a living thing produces their young ones are called reproduction. The process of producing the young ones of an organism is called reproduction. So the process reproduction. So reproduction is a process by which a living thing produces their young ones are called reproduction. Reproduction means the process by which a living thing produces their young ones are called reproduction. And then animals, different animals reproduce in different ways. So some animals give birth to their young ones and some other animals or birds lays egg. So such a way that animals, different animals reproduce differently. And so reproduction means the process by which a living thing produces their young ones are called reproduction. And reproduction is not necessary for each and every living being, as like or as respiration, digestion, etc. So reproduction is not an important factor. And this is because reproduction does not affect the present life of an individual, and all living things can live completely well without reproduction. All living things can live completely well without reproduction. Because reproduction is not necessary like respiration, digestion, etc. And some animals, different animals reproduce in different ways. So let us see what are the different ways animals reproduce. So reproduction means the process by which a living thing produces their young ones are called reproduction. And the next topic is ways of reproduction. Ways of reproduction. So there are two ways of reproduction in animals. There are two ways of reproduction in animals. Two ways of reproduction in animals. They are, some animals give birth to their young ones and some animals lay eggs from which young ones hatch out. Okay, so the first way is give birth to their young ones by giving birth to babies or young ones. By giving birth to babies. And the next way is by laying eggs. by laying eggs from which N1s hatch. So there are two main ways of reproduction in animals, that are by giving birth to babies and by laying eggs. Birds are reproduced through laying eggs. So these are the two different ways to reproduction. So reproduction means the process by which a living thing produce their N1s are called reproduction. And there are two main ways to of reproduction. They are by giving birth to their babies and by laying eggs. So these are the two ways to reproduction. And the first one is animals that give birth to their young ones. The animals that give birth to their young ones are called mammals. Okay. The animals that give birth to their young ones and nourish with the milk are called mammals. So, what do you mean by mammals? The animals that give birth to young ones and nourish them with milk are called mammals. The animals. So we can say that we say that mammals means the animals that give birth to their young ones and also nourish them with milk are called mammals. And mammals have hair on their body. They have. Mammals take care of their babies and then the babies grow bigger and strong enough to take care of themselves. Then the babies become grow, they can take care of themselves. So these are the important factors of futures of mammals. Mammals have hair on their body and also the young ones of mammals feed on mother's milk. Feed on mother's milk till they learn to find food and feed themselves. Then they take care of their babies. Mammals take care of their babies. These are the important features of mammals. So mammals means the animals that give birth to their young ones and nourish them with milk are called mammals. Examples for mammals are cow, goat, lion, cat. Are examples for mammals, and human beings are also example for mammals because human beings give birth to their young ones and also nourish the young ones with milk. And the babies or the young ones of mammals formed inside the mother's body and they stay inside the mother's womb for several months or several weeks. Then they are fully formed. They comes out the mother's body when we can say that they are born. Then the main features of mammals are the hair. Mammals have hair on their body. Mammals have hair on their body. Then the young ones of mammals feed on their mother's milk and also their mother. The mammals take care of their babies and the young ones feed on mother's milk till they learn to fight food and feed themselves. When the young ones of mammals grow up, they can take care of themselves. Okay, so these are the important features of mammals. And the next one, egg-laying animal. So already we said that there are two ways for reproduction, that is give birth to young ones and by laying eggs. The first one is give birth to their young ones, and the animals that give birth to their young ones and nourish them with milk are called mammals. And the next one is by laying eggs. Egg-laying animals. Egg-laying animals. There are many animals like birds, reptiles, frogs, snakes. Snakes are reptiles and fishes are laying eggs. They reproduce by laying eggs. Some insects also reproduce by laying eggs. So egg-laying animals, examples for egg-laying animals are birds, reptiles, next one, frog. Fish. These are egg-laying animals. Okay. So the birds when the egg get matured, they hatch and their eggs comes out. When the egg matured. When the egg matured, they hatch and the egg one is comes out. So birds, reptiles, frogs, fishes are examples for egg-laying animals. Then when the egg is matured, the egg is hatched and the egg one is comes out. So an egg has main three main parts that are animals reproduce through. Some birds, reptiles, frog and fishes reproduce through by laying eggs, and one egg has three main parts. Egg has three main parts of egg. Parts of egg. The main three main parts of an egg are shell, albumen, that is white albumen, then yellow yolk, these are the three main parts of an egg, shell, albumen, then yolk. So an egg has different parts. Shell, albumen and yolk. Shell, white albumen and yellow yolk. And the first part is shell. In your textbook, here a picture of an egg is given. And here this is an egg. See, this is albumen. Then egg shell. This is yellow yolk. The yellow color material is called yellow yolk. And the first part is shell. Shell is the outer covering of an egg. Shell is the outer covering of an egg, which protect the babies inside the egg. Shell is the outer covering of an egg. Outer covering. Present within the shell is called the albumen. So the different parts of an egg is shell, albumen and yolk. Shell means the outer covering of an egg is called the shell, and the shell protect the baby inside the egg. And next one is albumen. Albumen is a white jelly like substance within the shell is called albumen. And the white albumen is rich in proteins, and the white albumen helps us to grow. Okay. So it is rich in proteins. The white albumen, which is rich in proteins. And the next part is yolk. The yellow inner part of the egg. The yellow inner part of the egg is called yolk. The yellow inner part of the egg. The third part is yolk. The yellow inner part of the egg is called yolk. So these are the different parts of an egg: shell, albumen, and yolk. Okay. So shell is the outer covering of an egg, and the shell protect the baby inside the egg. And the next part is albumen, and albumen is the white jelly substance present within the egg shell, and the albumen is very rich in proteins. And the third part is yolk. The yellow inner part of the egg is called yolk, and the yellow yolk provides nutrients to the baby inside the egg. So function of yolk is the growing baby gets food through the yolk. The growing baby gets the food through the yolk. So the yolk provides food for the growing baby. It is the main food provided for the growing baby. It provides food for the baby inside the egg. So the main function of yolk is provides food for the baby. So these are the three main parts of an egg. What are the main parts of the egg? Shell, albumen, and yolk. So today we are learned about reproduction in animals. Reproduction means the animals, some living things produce their young ones, and this process is called reproduction. And there are two main ways of reproduction, that is give birth to their young ones and by laying eggs. Okay, so reproduction means the process by which an animal or any living thing produce their young ones are called reproduction. And the ways of reproduction are by giving birth to their young ones and by laying eggs. And the animals that give birth to their young ones and nourish them with milk are called mammals. And examples for mammals are cow, goat, human beings, etc. are examples for mammals. And the main features of mammals are they have hair on their body. And they also nourish the young one with milk, and their young ones feeds on their mother's milk till they are led to find food and feed themselves. And always the mammals take care of their babies. And main feature of mammals are the young ones of a mammal formed inside the mother's body, and they stay inside the mother's womb for many weeks or months. Then they are fully formed, then they comes out from the mother's body, then we can say that they are born. Okay, so the main features of mammals are animals like bears, tigers, cows, and cats, dogs, and even human beings that give birth to their babies, and they are called mammals. And the mammals have hair on their body. And their young ones feed on their mother's milk. the young ones of mammals feed on their mother's milk and till they learn to find food and feed themselves. Always mammals take care of their babies until the babies grow bigger, bigger and strong to enough to take care of themselves. And the next way is egg-laying animals. And the next way to way for reproduction is by laying eggs. And the egg-laying animals are birds, reptiles, frogs, and some insects are also reproduced by laying eggs. And when the eggs get mature, they hatch and the young ones comes out. When the egg is mature, the egg is hatched and the young ones comes out. And different animal, the eggs of different animals are different size and shape. And hence, showing an example, an egg has three main parts, that are shell, albumen and yolk. Shell means the outer covering of an egg is called shell. The outer covering of the egg, that is hard covers and the soft inner parts and protect the growing baby from outside occurrence are called shell. Simply, shell is the outer covering of the of an egg and which protect the baby. So inside the egg, so shell is the outer covering of the egg and the shell protect the baby inside the egg. And next part is albumen. Albumen is a white jelly-like substance, and present within the eggshell. And albumen is a white jelly-like substance. The white jelly-like part of an egg is called albumen. The white jelly-like substance of an jelly-like part of the egg is called albumen. And it is rich in proteins. Albumen is rich in protein. The part of an egg rich in protein is albumen. And the next part is yolk, yellow yolk. The yellow inner part of an egg is called yolk. So the main function of the yolk is it is provide the food for the animals. Sorry, food for the baby inside the egg. So yolk is the main food provided for the growing baby. And the growing baby gets food through the yolk and grows big and finally comes out a chick from the egg. Okay, so egg-laying animals lay a large number of eggs. Egg-laying animals lay a large number of eggs. And then some survivors, many of the eggs and babies are eaten by other animals. So these are the three important main parts of an egg. So reproduction is not necessary for each and every individual, each and every living things, because reproduction does not affect the present life of an individual, and all living things, living beings can live completely well without reproduction. So reproduction means, reproduction is the process by which an animal produce their young ones are called reproduction, and the animals that give birth to their young ones and nourish them with milk are called mammals. Okay, so the time period of which an animal generally lives is called its lifespan. Okay, lifespan. Lifespan, the time period for which an animal lives. The time period of which an animal lives. The time period for which an animal lives is called its lifespan. Okay, and we already learned that some animals reproduce through by laying eggs, and the birds make nests when they are ready to lay eggs, and the mother bird lays eggs in the nest and sit on them to keep the warm and safe. When the embryo in the egg gets warm, then the eggs of the birds hatch and the baby comes out. Okay, so by laying eggs, the birds make nest for laying eggs. And like that, some other egg laying animals also make some ways for laying eggs, and that we will discuss in our next class. And today the portion lifespan means time period for which an animal lives is called as lifespan. The time period for which an animal lives, how long the animals live, how many years animal live is called its lifespan. Okay, lifespan means the time period for which an animal live. The time period for which an animal lives is called its lifespan. Okay, so now let us discuss some questions that we learned in this class. Okay, so take the page number 147. Tick the correct answer. The first question is, the time period for which an animal and plant lives is called its lifespan. So the answer of first question is lifespan, that we also studied in this class. And the second question, animals that give birth to young ones and feed on their mother's milk are called mammals. The animals that give birth to their young ones and nourish them with milk are called mammals. Mammals feed on their young ones. Okay, so answer mammals. Then there are three more questions that we will discuss in our next class. And the fill in the blanks question, most birds build dash to lay eggs. Most of the birds build nest to lay eggs, and they lay eggs on the nest and they sit upon the eggs and to obtain warm, then it starts to grow inside it. Then the last three questions we discuss in our next class. So today we are discussed about reproduction and type ways of reproduction. So the important things that we studied in this class are reproduction, mammals and ways of reproduction. Okay, reproduction is the process by which a living thing produce their young ones are called reproduction. And there are two main ways for reproduction: give birth to their young ones and by laying eggs. Some animals give birth to their young ones and feed milk to their young ones. Such types of animals are called mammals. Human beings is a mammal. Okay, then next one is by laying eggs. Some birds and reptiles, frog, fish, etc. laying eggs. They reproduce by laying eggs. So, and always also studied about different parts of an egg. An egg has three parts, which are shell, albumen and yolk. Shell is the outer covering of the egg, which protect the babies inside the egg. And the next part is albumen. It's a white jelly-like substance present in the eggshell is called albumen. And albumen is very protein rich. And the next one is yolk. The yellow inner part of an egg is called yolk, and the yolk provides food for the baby inside them. Okay, so you read the test carefully and study well. Thank you.